Hey there. So we are going to talk about building custom renderers with React. How many of you know what is a custom renderer? Nobody knows? Okay. We'll talk about it. My name is Satyajit Sahoo. I work at Callstack. I am also a core contributor to React Native. You can follow me at Satya164 on Twitter, GitHub, and Medium. Okay, so let's get to it. So, what is a custom renderer? A custom renderer is an alternative target for rendering a React component. What does it mean? So, you have used React on the web, right? You install the React DOM package. So, the React DOM package allows you to render React components in the browser. Similarly, there are other renderers like React Native, which allow you to render React components into native platform components. So that's basically a custom renderer. React Native is a renderer, React DOM is another renderer, and I will give some examples of other renderers. But why do you build custom renderers? React is so good because of its declarative and component-based API, right? What if we could use the same API for everything? For example, in native apps, we had to use Java and Objective-C with very different APIs, right? You are used to writing web apps in React, and you know how React works, you know the functional approach of building apps. You can reuse the same knowledge to write native apps. You can also reuse the same knowledge to write other kind of apps like command line apps or any kind of apps. You just have to imagine what you want to write. There are some examples of what can be built and what has been built. So this is the first one is React Tiny DOM. It's a very small implementation of React DOM with a custom renderer API. The second one is React Test. It's a custom renderer to write terminal-based apps in React. So you can write CLIs and other stuff in React Test. Then there is React Stream Renderer, which allows you to render your stream. So you can use the same thing to write terminal-based apps. For example, you can render things to process.htdout, which is a stream. Then there is React PDF. It allows you to render React components into PDF documents. Redocx allows you to render React components into Microsoft Word documents. React Hardware allows you to control hardware with React. Then React SketchUp. You know Sketch? How many of you know Sketch? Okay, so Sketch is basically a design tool for Mac. It's similar to Illustrator or Photoshop, but it is optimized for designing mockups and that kind of stuff. This is a screenshot of React SketchUp. You can write some code on the left in React, and it renders to Sketch on the right. This is built by Airbnb. I think it is called React SketchUp. You can search. I'll share the links in the end, so you can check it with your check it yourself. So this is a game I built in React Stream Renderer for. Also built in React. How many of you know Flipboard? Okay, so Flipboard also made an app, made a custom renderer in Canvas API. So they used HTML5 Canvas API to write 60 frames per second apps on the web. So they wrote it very long ago. I think it was during React 14 or something. I don't remember. So it didn't use the latest React Reconciler API that is available in React 16 that we are going to use today. Okay, so what will we build? We'll also build a canvas-based renderer API, similar to what Flipboard built. But it will be very small. We'll have only one thing called rectangle. It will just render a rectangular box on screen. You can add more functionality later. This is how it will look, just a black rectangle. Okay, so before we get into some terminology, so that we are familiar with different things when we are building it. So first thing is fiber. How many of you know what fiber is? But how many of you know heard of fiber? Like, there was a website, isfiberready.com. How many of you know about the website? Yeah, so okay, so not a lot of people know what fiber is. So fiber is basically the latest reconciliation API of React. The reconciliation algorithm of React. Before React 16, the reconciliation algorithm was called Stack Reconciler. But in React 16, they rewrote everything. They rewrote the diff algorithm. You know it by virtual DOM diffing. So now it is called fiber. Why is it called fiber? Does anybody know why is it called fiber? No. So fiber is a data structure called fiber internally. That's why it is named fiber. So what is reconciliation? Reconciliation is the virtual DOM diffing algorithm. It is the algorithm that React uses to get from one state to another. React looks at both of the trees, it figures out what to change. So that is the reconciliation algorithm. This is the shape of a fiber object, the data structure that React uses. It has some properties, it's not important for now. I'll show the fiber if you cannot see this. Okay, so let's build it. So, for building the custom renderer, we have to look at the structure it will produce. Right? So, how will the structure look? So, if you look at a web page, what we have a page, then we have some nodes, document, body, paragraph, div, span, right? These are all nodes. So, basically, a web page is made of a lot of different kind of nodes, and there is a container which contains all of the nodes. So that's what we need. We need a container and we need to write some nodes. Our container will contain the nodes. We have only one type of node, rectangle, right now. You can implement more yourself. And so we like two different classes for container and rectangle. So, I talk about nodes. So, what exactly is a node? And what exactly is a React element? Do you know the difference between nodes and React elements? No. Okay, so basically, a node is a DOM node. Then, when you say document, the create element, div, it produces a node. But when you write div like this in JSX, it produces an element. You can use this React DOM API, render find DOM node, to get a node from an element. Okay, so enough about nodes and elements. Let's write our renderer. So the first thing is we'll write a container class. It's very simple, it will have a JSON array, then it will have some methods. That method will only modify the array. A print child will append the child to the array. Remove child will remove something from the array. And then there is another method called invalidate, which will basically trigger a redraw of the canvas. And then there is the rectangle class, which is very similar. It has only one extra method called replace props. It is used to update the properties of the rectangle. So this will be our public API. You have used React DOM, right? You have a method called react-dom.render. So that method is called when you are rendering graph for the first time. So we'll also have a method called render. It will take two arguments, it will take an element and it will take a canvas. Then we create a container and then we call canvas renderer that update container. So what exactly is canvas renderer? You know what container is, we wrote the class. But what exactly is canvas renderer? Canvas renderer is the implementation of our custom renderer. And we'll see how to build that. Okay, so there is a new package called react-reconciler in React 16 that allows us to build a custom renderer. It exports a function. That function will take the object called postConfig, and then the config object will implement various methods to create and mutate our tree. Okay, so this will be basically the methods. I have listed all the methods here. So the first three methods are for creating the tree, and then there is a mutation object which has methods for updating. I'll discuss all the methods in detail. So first one is create instance. It's very simple. You get type and props as arguments, and you return a rectangle instance. Basically, you can have different kind of elements like circle or any kind of shape, and you just return the instance of the class we created earlier, right? So then there is create text instance. We just return the string we receive. In your implementation, you can have a custom class if you want to like customize the text mode. For example, in one mode, you can have multiple strings and you can have styles, etc. So, you can do something like that. So, to keep it simple, we just return the text here. Okay, the next method is append initial child. So this method is called a React. For the first time you render the app. When the tree is created for the first time, React will call this method so that you can append some children to the tree. It is just called parent instance plus append initial child. What is parent instance here? Parent instance is the instance of the container class we created earlier. That container class has a method called append initial child. We just call that method and pass the child. And what it will do is called this.children.push child. That's all it does. Okay, so these are the methods we're creating. Next thing is mutation. Next thing is we have to mutate the tree after creating it. So this is our tree. I mean, we don't have actually a tree, we have only rectangle nodes inside a kind of. So this is our container. We have some rectangles inside that. Let's call that 0, 1, 2, 3. So the first method, append child to container, appends a new child to the array. It adds the child to the end of the array. Next one, insert in container before. It allows you to insert a child before another child. For example, I am saying that I want to insert this child before the element called 1. So that's what it is doing. React calls this method with two arguments. The first one is the child we need to insert, and the second one is before what. So that's what it is. Next one is remove child from container. It's straightforward. You remove something from the array. Append child is similar to append child to container. The only difference is the first one was container and the children were rectangles. Here the container is the rectangle and these are rectangles children, which will be text if you want to have some text inside the rectangle. Similar insert before, we just have a rectangle instead of a container and we have text instead of rectangles. And similar, remove child. Okay, after calling all these methods, we have now created the tree. Then we have updated the tree. The last thing is we need to trigger a re-render, right? So we have to call this method, commit update. So commit update will take new props and it will take the old tree. Then it will apply the new props to create the new tree. Okay, that's all. Now I want to show you the demo of what we made. Okay, so this is what we made, is just a rectangle. We move our mouse. It moves. Okay, can you see it? We basically import React. We create a React component. We have some state. Then we just add some listener, some mouse move, and then we update the state. This is some animation library we are using to update the state. And this is our render function. Basically, has a rectangle, some styles, some text. That's all. So, also, I'll show another cool thing with this. You can actually integrate with this Chrome DevTools. So you can inspect what is happening. Okay, you can see the state here, and you can see it updating. You can inspect the tree. We have arc. We have the rectangle. Then you can inspect the objects. So yeah, pretty straightforward. To integrate with DevTools, you basically have to do this. You have to call canvas renderer to inject into DevTools. You have to pass some configuration. That's all. Okay, so if you want to check the final implementation, it is available in this link, github.com/satya164 React Canvas Renderer. You can follow me on Twitter if you want to ask for the slides. I'll share the slides on Twitter. And these are some resources to learn how to build custom renderer. The first one is Fiber. What is Fiber? Is a capital intro to Fiber by Lynn Clark. You should watch this, it's a very good intro to understand the Fiber intro. Then this one is a tutorial to write a custom renderer. This is also a tutorial to write a custom renderer. This is the source code of the React-reconciler package, and these are some list of awesome renderers.